The New Orleans Pelicans have got a humongous burst from Rajon Rondo. You can check it out at youtube.com/TYT Sports when we discuss that. Yeah, we should discuss this man. He came from Montenegro, was drafted by the Chicago Bulls, took his time coming over, and it is Nikola Mirotic. How ironic that him and Bobby Portis are dapping each other up, yet also not ironic that Nikola Mirotic is not looking in his way. And then there's Mirotic, and then there's Pelicans Mirotic. How the F is that the same person? Chicago Bulls Mirotic, Pelicans Mirotic. Bulls Mirotic, Pelly's Mirotic. I can't believe that's the same person. So NBA Reddit had this to say, proved he's a fantastic player. The Bulls are 14-11, 13-44 without him. Of course, that's with his injury, Bobby Portis being out with a suspension, and then other players being injured along the way and just simply getting rest. Zach LaVine not playing on a back-to-back. Pelicans are 22-10 when Mirotic does play, 28-24 without him. Pretty convincing numbers, 11 rebounds, 3 assists, 4 blocks, 2 steals, 1 turnover, 16 points in their first win against the Blazers. And guess what? He continues to do it. Now, Yahoo put this out. The Bulls sold high on a player, averaging 17 per clip, hitting nearly 43% of his threes. Didn't match that production in New Orleans. He struggled, picked it up late. They had a 10-game winning streak, 17 points per in that winning, in a 5-game winning streak. 17 points per, 5-game winning streak to end the year. He averaged 26-13 on 56% shooting. As we went over previously, Rajon Rondo has benefited from the services of Nikola Mirotic. Anthony Davis has really benefited as well, because this is another guy who can space the floor and has to keep his defender at bay and keep his defender very close to him. So that's why you're gonna have success in the pick and roll, where you're basically setting up a 2-on-2 game. And if anybody, an Al-Farouq Aminu, a Mo Harkless, any others, an Evan Turner, any others that wanna try to guard Nikola Mirotic and they sag, that's when and why the Pelicans have been winning so many games. Yes, Jrue Holiday is having a great year, but Nikola Mirotic is helping out this effort in ways that the Chicago Bulls thought that they would get, and they did have when they started out 3-10. They won 7 games straight earlier on when Mirotic came back, and then they're like, whoa, we were playing way too good. What we need to do is try to suck for Luka Doncic. We need to suck for DeAndre Ayton. And quick caveat, this is how bad of a franchise the Bulls are. Even when they try to be bad, they're good. Like, the Bulls have the 6th or 7th best chance, 6th or 7th worst record in the NBA. They were shooting for top 3. That's how much of a clusterfuck the franchise is. All right, lastly, the floor spacing big man, he's not big, but he's stretched four, has produced a combined 33 points over the first 2 games, shooting a solid 46%, 41% from 3-point range. Just been impressive on the boards, 9 and a hook, 3 blocks over the first pair of contests against the Blazers as well. This is a perfect matchup for him. It is a match made in heaven for the New Orleans Pelicans, because they are shutting down Damian Lillard. They are helping out to shut down and aid in the shutting down of CJ McCollum. And guys like Nikola Mirotic are lighting them up. So kudos to the front office for the New Orleans Pelicans for putting together deals like this. Yes, they sold the first round pick, but can you imagine what this team would be like, what these playoffs would be like, if they did have Boogie Cousins back and had a solid 1-5 of Rondo, Jrue Holiday, Nikola Mirotic, Anthony Davis, and Boogie Cousins? I believe they have him for 1 more year at well over $10 million. See what the sample size is next year, and if it works out, New Orleans could be the next big, scary team in the Western Conference.